this is awesome.
We have strange miracles here tonight. Celebrate Jesus for this great miracles. People from all over the world, tell me,
Papa, for 20 years she was suffering from chronic back pain and arthritis. She could not bend, and even sitting on a closet to poo-poo was a major challenge. But tonight, as you ministered, the power of God came upon her. She can bend, she can do what she could not do, to the glory of God. Ben,
you are hearing testimonies and you are just complacent. Come, Pastor, listen to them. Let them get outstanding ones for you. You are free now. You know what she's telling me now? She says she's totally free now. You see, but her son is with her. For many years, he has been having crisis. Why are you not grateful for what God has done for you? Be grateful. Thank Him. If you can do your own, you can do your son. Woman, go and bring your son. Go and bring your son.
Papa, the testimony of the young man that was taken by Pastor Henry, he can lift the hand to the glory of God.
Lift your hand. Come. Father, thank you for restoring his mind.
Merci d'avoir restauré.
He's totally free.
Il est totalement libéré.
Awesome, awesome.
Oh,
leave him, leave him. No, you will join him. Next time, you don't hold people like that. You are not an usher. Give God a shout wherever you are. Blessed
Papa,
be the name
God
of God.
God is doing amazing thing here tonight.
With doctor's report.
Another report. A report from a doctor.
Leave her alone.
Another report of a fibroid since last year.
Come.
And the amazing thing is this. She said the thing has been there and very, very heavy. That right now she cannot even feel it again.
Give God a shout of appreciation.
Hallelujah.
God cannot lie. His word must surely come to pass. He will never lie. God is not man.
His word must surely come to pass.
He is not a man.
Because he's not a man.
God cannot lie.
His word must surely come to pass.
He will never lie.
Because
he's not a man. God cannot lie.
His word must surely come to pass.
He's not a man. God cannot lie.
His word must surely come to pass.
He will never lie.
Because he's not a man.
God cannot lie.
His word must surely come to pass.
He will never lie.
Because he's not,
because he's not a man. God cannot lie.
His word must surely come to pass.
He will never lie.
Because he's not a man.
God cannot lie.
His word must surely come to pass.
He will never lie.
Because he's not a man.
God cannot lie.
His word must surely come to pass.
He will never lie.
Because he's not a man.
God cannot lie.
His word must surely come to pass.
He will never lie.
Because he's not a man.
God cannot lie.
His word must surely come to pass.
He will never lie.
Because he's not a man.
God cannot lie.
His word must surely come to pass.
He will never lie.
Because he's not a man.
God cannot lie.
His word must come to pass.
He will never lie.
Because his word is man.
God cannot lie.
His word must surely come to pass.
He will never lie.
Because his word is man.
Sister, I know it like I know my name. The fire rod will never return again.
Papa, sir, this lady said she went to the hospital and she was diagnosed to have what they call sympathetic. That's what you said, sympathetic. And she has been booked for an operation. But while you prayed tonight, she just discovered that the symptoms, everything is gone. By the
everything
power of God.
Is gone. Come here. Hallelujah. Now you go spend your money on something else. You are healed.
Papa, this is a miracle, sir. This man could not work for 1 year now. But why you are missing just that the clutches it came with inside his car? The daughter just come to bring the clutches. She,
thank you, Jesus. I can walk now.
You can see the two leg was crippled. A vehicle jam hit him. As his last year, he could not walk. They carried him here, sir.
He was carried.
He was carried here. See what Jesus has done.
Are you just celebrate Jesus? Celebrate Jesus. Watch me, watch me.
We had a Jesus just a great show. But for the show,
all I require for life,
all I require for life,
God has given me.
I
am a chosen generation.
We are a chosen generation. Both on the shore is excellent. All I require for that.
God has given me.
I know who I am.
We are the crutches.
I know who God says I am. What he says I am. Yeah, he says I am.
I know who I am.
I'm
walking in power,
I'm walking in power,
I'm
walking in miracles, I live a life of a God.
I'm walking in power,
yeah, yeah. I'm walking in power, I live a life of a God. Cause I know who I am.
It doesn't matter what you say now.
See his glory. I know who I am. Take a look at me, I'm a wonder. It doesn't matter what you say now. See his glory.
Take a look faster.
I know who I am. Take a look at me, I'm a wonder. See his glory. I know who I am. Take a look at me, I'm a wonder. It doesn't matter what you say now. See his glory. I know who I am. Take a look at me, I'm a wonder. It doesn't matter what I see now. See his glory. I know who I am. Take a look at me, I'm a wonder. It doesn't matter what I see now.
Rejoice!
See his glory. I know who I am. Take a look at me, I'm a wonder. It doesn't matter what I see now. See his glory.
walking. Who owns that?
Jesus.
Put your hands up. Come on.
Put your hands up. Put your hands up.
Wait, listen. That man that ran out to grab me, I will not pray for you, because your act is an act of faithlessness. When somebody can see me stand there and I'm praying, and he runs to me, he say, help me. To do what? It's the same thing that I've said on the pulpit. I will still say, I'm not a herbalist. So people like that, you don't pray for them. It's not faith. It is doubt. A native doctor can't help you unless you see him one-on-one. But a man of God, you don't need to see him one-on-one. The difference between a man of God and a herbalist is that you don't need to see. There are some of you who are waiting that you travel the way down. You want to see Apostle one-on-one. Now, there is something people say. Listen, if you say it again in this place, they will not take your testimony. I came first time. I was not located. It is a demonic statement. The word of God is the greatest location. When somebody comes and say, I was not located, they are looking for a herbalist, not Jesus.
Leave the road.
What they call location is that they didn't call their name. That is wrong. Your, everything about your case is inside prayer. People say, Apostle, how come you didn't preach? How many of you have been preaching since I heard this mic? I've been preaching. But there are traditional Christianities that you now sit down, open toe, turn toe. You see, the mindset of people. Herbalist is not man of God. A herbalist will tell you, come, let me see you. But a man of God, Jesus Christ was going to that man's house. The man said, stop! Don't bother. Send the word. If you came here and there's a problem with you, all that matters as I'm praying, say, Lord, everything this man of God is, for me. Change my case. Just being under the atmosphere of a prophet, your life has changed. So to run to him, oh, you're like, oh, pray for me, is a sign that you have no faith. You believe that until he touch you. And a true Christian will not do that. In those days, I used to have sympathy for people like that. God said to me, stop it. They don't have faith. You can't help them. If I'm praying here, you don't believe. You now come to my office. The same prayer is what I was still praying. There's no special. And those who know me can tell you, you don't spend more than 1 minute with me. So if you are waiting for us to sit down and talk, you are a joker. You can't spend more than 30 seconds. If you say, I came because, shh. So I don't have such time. It is heartlessness to see a man who has a worldwide ministry and does not rest. If you send me an SMS and say, Papa, I want to see you one-on-one, I don't reply. Such messages, I don't reply. Because if you need a miracle, it's not me you need. It's a miracle. Papa, speak the word. That's all. I'll reply. So, in case you don't get replies, when you say, I want to see you one-on-one, it's because, come on. I came from Zambia. I went to Côte d'Ivoire. As we are landing in Côte d'Ivoire, I went to partners meeting. I finished partners meeting, it's almost past 7. I went to pastors all night. We finished an all night. I finished morning. My wife can tell you, I've been writing. There's a book I've been writing. Finish and I'm here. Tomorrow I'll do service. I'll do Jehovah the Doctor. And that kind of man, you say you want to sit him down or be talking to him? You're heartless. All you need is a word. A word.
Hallelujah.
That's why many prophets have deceived many of you, collected your money. Because you like this African thing. A man of God sends a word, but a herbalist says, see me. If the Holy Spirit impressed, there were some people I said to see me.
Thank you, Jesus.
The Holy Ghost impressed, I'll see you. But if you walk to me without it being God's plan, let me tell you something. People who emphasize on seeing a man of God one-on-one, check it, they have seen many men of God. When they see that man of God, they will add him to the list of those they have seen. It's the same faithlessness. And I refuse to be counted among the list.
Thank you, Jesus. My father can walk.
Papa, this is a miracle, sir. This man, when ministry just that stroke just fade away by the power of God.
Where are they from? Where are you from?
Anambra.
Anambra. Your dad can walk now. Let him walk. Come, Papa. And you are just standing and doing nothing.
Hallelujah.
Papa, there is another outstanding miracle here.
I just heard there is a child that is crying inside the Audi car. That the mom locked the child inside the car. There's a child inside an Audi. If anybody is sleeping, wake up the person. Audi, a child is crying inside. Tell me.
There is another outstanding miracle here from one of our viewers.
Go ahead and just say
it. Niger State, Jessica by name. She was having a swollen stomach after a childbirth for over 2 years. As you are praying right now, the power of God came upon her and she's totally healed.
The stomach has reduced.
Totally.
From Niger. Give God a clap offering.
Papa, sir. There is another one here from South Africa.
From South Africa.
From Water Chukwuemeka. You have been having pain for many months now. But while you were ministering, the power of God hit him. And now the pain is gone.
Give the Lord a celebrative clap offering. Permanent. Permanent. No, don't call me, sir. Stand up. It's permanent. Yes, thank you, Apostle. Not thank you, sir. He brought you from Anambra. Thank you, Father. Your brother has stroke. Okay. You are healed. Are you a twin? Are you a twin?
A twin.
Wait. Hold me. Hold me with your two. Hold me. Your two hands. All right. Your brother has stroke. Go down. As you hold me, hold your brother. Tell him to start walking. Go. Go, go, go. What are you waiting for?
Mama, there's another testimony.
Another testimony.
Another testimony from Sister Glory. From Worry, she has chest pain and a growth on one of her eyes. But right now, while you were ministering, the growth disappeared.
Give
the
God a shout.
Cease.
Give you the love for me.
Papa has been using this for how long? Come now. Leave him, leave him, leave him. You are smiling. Is it your dad?
Oh, belongs to
you. Congratulations.
Belongs to you.
Come.
Belongs.
Belongs to you. Listen, this is the finger of God. And it, listen, the miracles you are seeing now, they didn't start today. Reverend Kingsley can testify. He's not, wait, where is Pastor Mike? Pastor Mike Akbodia, please come. Come, please come. This man has been my friend for 21 years. This, we used to pray. We used to go to the mountain. You know, they don't understand. Those who are busy criticizing, they don't understand. They think it just started. Did it just start? Wait, one minute. Tell us a few things.
You see, when I was there, I still remember. You do say, Pastor Akoria, it will happen. Frankly speaking, we have known for about 22 years now. He's not just a friend, he's a brother. I call him Covenant Brother. There was something you said many years ago when we were praying. You said, Pastor Cordia, we need to pray for the prophetic eyes and prophetic ears and prophetic mouth. I said, okay. We prayed that night seriously, and I will tell you the truth. I have seen the manifestation in my life. Now, there's something I discovered in Apostle Suleiman. Whenever he comes to pray, whenever he comes around me, my home is the second home. It's second home. He doesn't sleep outside. Very rare. Because if he does it, it's going to be a problem between her and the mother. But when he slept my house, and tell the mother that he slept my house, the mother will find out from me. And if I say it's yes, say that's it to it. Because the mother believe in me, even to date. And when we are praying, I live in an austere. I discover three things in him. When he comes around, I was working in the summer. I used to close in the evening. So he will come around 7, 8 o'clock. So after, when we are praying in the night, when he comes, I say, let's go to the bed and sleep. He said, no, I want to lie on the chair. I said, why do you want to lie on the chair? So that I can wake up on time. I said, no problem. Sleep on the bed. I will wake you. As long as you are here, you must wake up by 12 p.m. He will still insist to say, I want to lie on the chair. He will lie on the chair. I still wondering, say, did Apostle Ma still lie on the chair? So when we are praying, my center table chair, he will used to be shaking the floor, shake everywhere. The next morning, I'm going to be in trouble. The tenant downstairs will say, Pastor, you didn't allow us to sleep last night. You were disturbing us, shaking everywhere. So when he come again, next time I'll say, please, take it easy. Don't shake table. But yet, he will still shake the table. So he didn't know, and I carry the table to this side of the wall. So when we are praying, I will stand by the table so that he will not shake the table. Very violent in prayer. Very violent. The Bible is written, the kingdom of God suffered violent, but the violent take it by force. It is by force. It is by force. Something that I was carrying on my lady back at that time. It will have gone with us now. Carry both of you on my back. Pastor Kisney, brother also, we carry them to the prayer ground. And when we are coming out, I go and drop him at home. We prayed always. He come around and say, Pastor, brother, are you doing this thing? I said, you're finished my 30 days all night. Are you doing it? I said, come around. And after we are praying the next morning, I was a senior bros. He said he want to bath. I will carry water to the bedroom for him to bath. Now listen, let me tell you something. Don't look down on a man that prays. For this over 2 decades now, we have known as a covenant brother, we have never hurt ourselves. Don't look down on a man that pray. You don't know a man when things are well. You don't know a man when things are rosary. You don't know a man in time of prosperity. You know a man who is a friend of yours in time of adversity. There was a time in this. Let me tell you something. There are two things in life man must experience: wilderness experience and his dark days. Apostle Johnson Suleiman, I call him great apostle. He have experienced his dark days. All you are seeing now is not just yesterday. He have experienced his dark days and his wilderness experience. That was the time of unknown. Nobody know him. And nobody cared to associate. And that was when we knew. There are two kinds of friends. Friends who can stand with you in your dark days. But when you are in your lighting days, they will heavy you. They will heavy you. It's not a friend. They are envious of your success. But a friend that can stand with you in your dark days and your lighting days is still with you is a friend. Pastor Kisley is a brother, is a friend. He knew him many years ago also. And they are still standing to today. You see a son to him. Celebrate this man. I also have something in Apostle Suleiman. When he comes around, he said, Pastor Mike, what do you have? I said, yeah, food. I have rice, I have tea. It's okay. I will eat rice. After I finish eating, Apostle Man will see demand for Gary. I'm sorry, I'm saying it here.